Hello everybody, it's Nina. Thanks for joining me today for a new tutorial. Today I'm very excited because I am bringing you some inspiration using this adorable Gingerbread Cubbies stamp and die set from Art Impressions. This darling set makes the most adorable peekaboo card. It has so many cute little gingerbread popping in and out of this fun little gingerbread house, and so I'm going to be showing you how I created this card using the set. So here is the finished Gingerbread Cubbies set, all finished. You can use the packaging of the stamp set as a great reference point as you're working on building this card. I'm going to start by stamping the images from the set onto some Nina white cardstock using some Simon Says Stamp Intense Black ink. I'll stamp the images and then start coloring them with my Copic markers. These images are small, so I'm going to be very simple with my coloring today, so that way I don't have to worry about trying to get too detailed on a smaller scale. I'm using some classic gingerbread colors here. I picked out a couple of E markers for the gingerbreads themselves, and then I'll use some lighter versions of those same markers, which are the E30 family, on the gingerbread house. I really love coloring images like this because they're so whimsical. You don't have to worry about being overly detailed with your coloring. The simpler your coloring is, the more this image actually stands out, in my opinion. I really love the whimsical look of the coloring, and I really love the whimsical look of the illustrations, which Art Impressions is so good with. So as I continue to color, I am bearing in mind that I'm going to be cutting out all of these images, and the house itself cuts out all of the windows. So I'm not going to color inside the actual windows themselves. However, if you weren't going to use the house as it's intended to be a cute little peekaboo card, you could color the inside of the windows. On all of the little gingerbread, I'm coloring some fun accents. There's also some great candy features in this particular stamp set, including a candy cane, lollipop, and gumdrops. And I've colored a ton of those for my images. Now, for all of the colors that I used here, I was inspired by the Pebbles Merry Little Christmas paper pack. There's a really great candy striped paper in that particular pad that I really wanted to incorporate into my card. So I used the colors in the pattern paper as a guide for my coloring. So if you have pattern paper that you want to use in this particular design, like I did for my card, make sure you grab the inspiration from the paper that you're going to use, because that really helps all the colors go so well together. Now, like I said, there are dies for these images, and in particular, this house. So you can see here, these little areas, including all the little windows, are going to get cut out. Same with the little gingerbread. I'm going to cut all of them out with the coordinating dies, and the lollipops, candy canes, wreath, and gumdrops. There are a ton of gumdrops that I used on my card. This took quite a bit of time to stamp all these out, and I actually stamped out even more than what I'm showing here on camera. And then I cut them all out with the coordinating dies. It took a little bit of time, but the end result is so worth it. However, if you did want to skip the gumdrops, you could decorate your gingerbread house using either sequins, or you could even add Nuvo drops. Those would be really fun too. For the background of my card, I decided to do a little bit of a pink blend background. I've really been loving the pink colors in my holiday cards this year. And this sponge sugar looks so good behind the gingerbread house. Just a nice pop of color, nothing too bright, really goes nicely with everything else. So I'm going to pop up my little house off of my background using some foam tape, and I'll start nestling some of these gingerbread into place before I attach the house down completely. This way I can kind of get an idea of where I want to put all of the images and make sure the placement's right before I have everything attached, and then I decide, uh-oh, that's not where I wanted to put it. So as I continue to place these images down, I'm also bearing in mind that I'm going to need to add a sentiment, which I am deciding to put on the left-hand side of my card. So I will leave some space over there for that. But I really love how you can put these gingerbread behind the door, in the windows, behind the windows, on the bottom portion of the little gingerbread house, because those actually open up. The door and the windows on the bottom part of the gingerbread house are very interactive, so this is really fun. And here's where I'm adding down all those little gumdrops. Now everything that I did adhere onto this card is popped up with foam tape, but you could make this card much more simpler by just using a little bit of liquid glue to adhere everything down. I just love the dimensions, so I went with foam tape on everything, and because I'm just a little bit crazy that way. Now here's where I decided to get a little sparkly. The Lawn Fawn Liquid Stardust is just stunning. It's this really great, intense shimmer that looks so good when you apply it down over top of your colored images, which is exactly what I'm doing here. I'm taking an empty glitter brush pen. I actually save these because you never know when these might come in handy. And so I used one of these empty ones as just the applicator for this. I actually thought afterwards that I should just actually fill this little empty bottle with some of that liquid stardust, and I think that I might do that here afterwards, but for now I'm just using it as an applicator, and I've done this already in a couple other cards, and I really love how this applies this liquid glitter down onto the card and creates this amazing shimmer on top of everything. This is really hard to capture on camera and in photos, but I do have some good photos that show the shimmer as best as possible, and in person this glitter is just beautiful. So like I said, I added this onto that candy stripe background. That card base looks beautiful, has a nice black sentiment that I added from the Gingerbread Cubbies stamp set, and everything is finished off with a few dots of Nuvo Drops to act as the snow in the background of my scene. This fun and festive card is so much fun to create, and I hope that you'll try out these really fun Cubbies stamps and coordinating die sets from Art Impressions, because I love them. They are so cute and so much fun. And check out how you can create some amazing interactive elements on your cards with very little effort. Thanks so much for tuning in today. Please be sure to stop back soon for more inspiration. And you can stop by our blog for more details on this card. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you again soon, and have a wonderful day. Bye!